help. I have done it again. I have been here many times before. Hurt myself again today.
I think there's norms that everyone wants to fall into, and when you can't, when you don't fall into those norms, you know, you just kind of become this walking facade sometimes. And I think that it's hard to be in college because there are so many norms and there's so many ideas of what you should be coming from family, from your peers, from your professors, from your college even.
People my age, when you have the stress of college, when you have the stress of getting good grades, peer pressure, everything, I think sometimes you lose sight of your potential, and you don't realize that there's so much out there for you.
If you don't have, you know, a boyfriend or a best friend or a person to talk to, or, you know, a way to relieve stress, it's usually those kids at my school who struggle with issues of suicide and depression.
I think one little thing, like, you know, a bad SAT score isn't the life-changing thing, but it's when you have that and you have, you're breaking up with your girlfriend or boyfriend, and you're breaking up, you know, like you're falling out of a social clique. That the combination just, I think it's overwhelming.
The life of a high schooler is very, can be very awkward and very uncomfortable for many people.
It's scary to think that one can get to a point where they only think death is the way out. And I think it scares people to think that, wow, maybe I could get to that point someday in my life. And I don't think anyone wants to think about that, but unfortunately, it does happen more often than we'd like to think.
More people should realize that it could happen to anybody. And it doesn't mean that they have issues, it just means that they need someone to talk to.
I just wish that the school would teach more about suicide, because they don't teach that much about it.
Every high school and even middle school should have someone come talk to them about it, because it's kind of something that's shunned to the side and no one really takes it seriously until it's touched their life.
This is a picture of my brother Mark, who committed suicide January 21st, 2005. He was 24 years old, and I was 12 when he died. At the time, I wasn't angry. I was just really sad, and
You have to listen in so many different ways. It's not just with your ears anymore. It's listening with the ability to pick up, to sense what's going on, because your children aren't going to put the words there. You have to listen to everything they say and all the ways they say it, and it's become incredibly hard to do that.
We aren't doing something right if that's such an easy alternative for them.
There's more power to listening than you'd ever know.
Just being able to talk to someone and probably changing their day, their week, their month, their year, it's an amazing feeling, and that's exactly what keeps me coming back.
Samaritans has helped me because they've taught me why my brother committed suicide, and that he didn't do it because he was angry at me. He did it because he had mental illness.
when you listen to someone, you kind of help them hear themselves.
If that's all I have to give is like 5 or 10 minutes of my time to help this person get through the rest of the week, then that's, yeah, I do feel like I'm making a difference.
When someone on the phone tells me that I'm the first person in a while who's actually wanted to talk to them, I feel like I've made a difference.
But when you do get that call that's like, that you, someone's in desperation and they really need your help, and at the end of the call, they say to you, you've really changed my day, you've made my day much better, you've convinced me out of doing something that I was gonna do, it just, that's the reason why I keep picking up the phone.
Yes, I did make a difference.
Kind of patience and maturity that you need to do this job is extraordinary, and you know, we're very proud that she has the ability to do that.
I'm actually proud, and I have this respect for Ari for all that she's done.
What Freddie took from this was the capacity to listen, and I, since it's not done frequently enough on any level, she can't help but benefit by that skill.
If I had one opportunity to say something to my peers, I would say, listen to somebody else. Because I feel like we drown out everything else with the noise of our own voices in an effort to get heard.
My life without Samaritans would probably be a wreck.
It's not a regret for the person, but it's a regret for the entire community that they leave behind, because that community could have and should have stepped in.
Suicidal people aren't necessarily lost, but they probably just need someone to find them